Now that the Arduino is wired up as a programmer, let's load the sketch. So go ahead and find the iMac G3 iPad init sketch and open it up in the Arduino development environment. Let's set it up to use the Arduino as a programmer. So the first thing we got to do is make sure you have, you know, the correct Arduino hooked up. And so I am using an Uno, so I've selected an Uno. The COM port that I'm using, or serial port rather, on Linux, they're named differently. On Windows, you'll see stuff like COM1 and COM2. And on Mac, you might see something similar to what you see here on Linux. So this is where mine is hooked up. I'm going to use it as a programmer, and it will be an Arduino as ISP, as you can see there. Okay, so we're going to load the programmer code onto the Arduino, and it comes with the examples in the Arduino development environment. So we can go to examples. We go down to Arduino ISP, which is number 11 in my version, and we select it. It'll open up a window with the code that you need. Now the wiring that I followed, and that you'll see here in the video, or that you saw in the video rather, is the wiring, you know, as described here. So if you wired it that way, if you wired it the way that's on the wiki, then this will work. So now it's just a matter of just uploading it to the Arduino. So now the Arduino is being programmed. It says done uploading. So now the Arduino is acting as a programmer, and we're going to use it to program the J20 board. Okay, so before we upload the code, I've had many people, you know, complain about it starting after they've loaded the code and then just turning off. And that's normal behavior. So let's go down to this line here, which I think is 173 or something like that. Okay. So the code has some, you know, a section here that monitors the vertical sync, and then there's a countdown built into this, and when it reaches zero, it'll turn, you know, the board off. And why does it do that? Well, that's a good way, you know, to detect whether or not you know, you've shut it down, like a soft, you know, shut off when you turn off your computer. Now this can cause some issues when you're first setting it up and developing it. So you can just, oops, let's go back to 173. Okay, or 179. You can just comment that for testing, and let's make sure there are no errors. We'll compile that real fast. And so now it's commented and it won't turn off. I need to turn it off for this video because actually the version of the board that I have installed doesn't have, it's an older version, and it doesn't have the trace to monitor it. So I need to turn that off anyhow. So once that's done, you should just go to tools, okay? Oh, I'm sorry, sketch, and then you upload using programmer. So when you do this, it's going to communicate to the Arduino, which is now programmed as a programmer, and then tell it that it's going to be sending it code that then the Arduino, via those lines that we hooked up, will program the J20 board. So we do that, and you'll see down here it says uploading, and I can see the Arduino TX and RX LEDs flashing, which is a good sign, and no errors. All right, it says done uploading. Now let's take a look at the iMac to see if it actually turns on. Now I'm going to hook up my laptop to the J20 board via its VGA connector. And if you can see on my screen there, maybe you could see, I don't know. It's only showing one display. Okay, and so I already have the one end of the VGA cable connected to the laptop, and now I'm going to take this end and plug it into the J20 board. At this point, the computer should automatically, and it did,
may be hard to see. You'll see there's a second display on there. And it sees it as an Apple Computer Inc. 13.3-inch display. Okay, so far so good.
All right. Now everything's wired up. It's plugged into power. All right. So let's turn this puppy on and see what happens. And there we are. We've got video.
Now I don't know how it's coming out in this recording. You're going to see the lines maybe, but that's okay. That's proof that it is a CRT. And so I'm going to move this over. And it's hard to see. But now we can see that that is on there. It really is on there. And that didn't take long at all. It was pretty easy. And so we can turn it off, I think, if I remember correctly, by just pressing the button for 5 seconds, maybe, and then letting it go. You can go over a little bit. There we go. Let's see if it remembers where it was. Yeah, it's working. So later on, I'll shoot a video wiring up audio. Maybe I have to replace these speakers because they're pretty rotted. So here I'm going to wire up my D-Rock amplifier. Okay. it's a 12-volt amplifier, and this will go wired into the breakout board up here later. But right now, this is my left out, this is my right out, and this here will be my input. Okay, so it's easy. You just take the output from your amplifier, whatever amplifier you decide to use. Okay, and this is my left. And we put it into the inputs here. The J22 board will accept, you know, wires here that go directly connected to the speakers. Okay. And I've already worked out the polarity. So I'm not going to go through that because every amplifier is different. But mine is like this. Okay. Now, for this setup, I'm going to do very little wire management. I just want to, you know, work out a video here. So I'm routing the cables this way. Okay, and I should be able to fit the hard drive caddy that I removed earlier. And then these will fit through an opening that's in the caddy, in between the caddy and the chassis. This is hard to do when you're shooting a video. Okay. And there we go. Fits nicely. All I gotta do is put in the screws now. And, you know, you can't see it in the video, but believe me that these wires fit through the gap that's in between the caddy and the chassis. Okay, and so now what I'll do is I'll wire up the power. So this is a 12-volt amplifier. We've got a barrel jack connector, okay? And we just have to hook that up to the breakout board. That goes connected to the down converter board. So there's a 12 volt out on here. I would just have to wire in. And then gotta hook that up to ground. So this barrel jack connector now is going to power the amplifier. Okay, so what's going to happen? Well, when the J22 board turns on and you press the button in the front, it's going to send a signal to the down converter board that will then convert the 48 volts AC coming from the analog board through the J22 board into standard 12 volt, 5 volt, and 3.3 volt voltages that you can use to power things. In this case, I'm using the 12 volts to power the amplifier. In another video, I powered a Raspberry Pi. And you can power a fan, whatever it is that you want to power with it. It's very convenient. I've also swapped out the board that I used earlier for one that's already modified to do the V-Sync detect. And I've also wired in the serial debugger in here, which I'm going to use later on to control it, you know, to adjust the settings on the monitor here with Oshimai's GUI. All right. Okay, so I've wired in a ground loop isolator, which is absolutely essential. When you hook this up, without that, what you'll get is staticky noise, you know, interference from the electronic, from ground loops. It's a thing. Yeah, look it up. It's annoying. But that will get rid of it. It was real cheap. I think it was like $7 on Amazon or something like that. All right. And so what I'm planning on doing is routing all the cables that I need to connect to a computer through the VGA, the old VGA port that was, you know, that cage here. So what I'll have is video coming out, VGA, audio input, and the serial debugger. You see the audio input, it comes in to the ground loop isolator, comes out of the ground loop isolator into the amplifier. And then the amplifier has the speaker outputs that go to the J22 board. All right, so I've wired everything in. I've done some routing, not much. And I had to modify the back of the RF shield here. I had to open it just a little bit. The reason I had to do that was because the DB15 or the DE15 connector that I'm using is just a little bit too wide and too long. You might be able to get away with something that's a little slimmer, or if you build your own and run the wires through before putting the connector on so that you don't have to do what I did, but it wasn't much of a modification. I cut a couple slits, one here, and then bent it. And I plan on bending it back once the shield is on. And sometimes here you'll get the connector for the speaker. It'll just get in the way. You just have to make sure you don't crimp the speaker wire in there. And so now this shield is on. Okay, and I just have to put on the six screws. So I'll start with maybe this guy here. That one went on a little hard. I think I might have cross-threaded it. So yeah, be careful not to cross-thread. Although these type of screws are a little bit more forgiving. Now, let's see. Try to get as much as possible in the view of my camera. Okay, the shield is on. Now I'm just gonna bend this back into place. Should have done this before. On the next try, I'll bend this back into place before assembling this. That's what I recommend. Okay. Bent back into place, bang up job, but you won't see it anyhow. I used an older one that I had to cut up, one that was kind of like ruddy. But yeah, it came out pretty good. So this part might be tricky.
she looks like it went into place on the first try. Okay. All right. So now, let's put the screws in. And this should be the reverse of what we did. And where are my screwdrivers? Okay. Okay. It looks good. Obviously this is not going to work because there's nothing there. Although I plan on making an adapter so I can put a modern, you know, Blu-ray in there. But for now, this is a monitor with speakers. You see the wires run out the back. Okay, so I have Minecraft up and running on my computer. This is the latest snapshot, whatever it is. It's going to go into 1.18. And it looks pretty cool. I think Minecraft was meant to be playing on CRT. It looks awesome. Okay. Wow, this looks really good. Really, really good. Let's see what the Nether looks like. It looks creepy. I don't know if you guys could hear all that, but there's a ghast, you know, flying around. But the audio does sound good. Uh-oh. Couldn't tell if those were zoglins or piglins. Here's my boat base. The boat that I'm rescuing. Or salvaging, rather. This looks really, really good on this iMac. Let's see what the boat base looks like from out here.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to see. Gotta get a little closer. That looks pretty good. Okay. Wow. Anyhow, yeah, this is a successful test. I mean, I need to do a couple of more things to this thing, but yeah, seems to be working. It's working great. Wow, I am pleased with the results. Wow, this is really, really nice. Really, really nice.